You're tuned into Sports from the Hoodwood, the internet's foremost location for the most honest, inspiring insight and opinion on the world of sports. Now, once again, here's the man of the hour, After Hours, your host, KJ Green.
Back in the Hoodwood once again, not necessarily the ghetto. I mean, some people say the Hoodwood may be the ghetto, but it's not. Hoodwood is where anyone is welcome to come by and hang out, talk sports, and have a good time. Maybe listen to old school here and there. But regardless of which, you're always welcome in the Hoodwood. And believe it or not, people in the Hoodwood like hockey. Believe it or not. Yes, I like hockey. And I talk about it here on the show regularly. Stanley Cup Final, split 1-1, headed back to Washington for game 3. Now, Vegas won game 1 in a thrilling 6-4 shootout, and maybe with it thought that the Stanley Cup Final was going to be a duel between two great goalies, Marc-Andre Fleury of the Knights and Braden Holtby of the Caps, but it turned out to be a scoring bonanza. It's the lead changed hands 4 times in game 1, and I'm sorry, I'm not really dissing the Golden Knights, the franchise themselves. I mean, they've put on a great product, and it seems like the fans in Las Vegas have really taken to hockey. But come on, hockey in June is bad enough. Hockey in June in Las Vegas, where the outdoor temperature at face-off at 5 o'clock in the evening, late afternoon evening, was 101 degrees. Come on now. But hockey purist that I am, I have to live with it. Now, game 2 was a 3-2 Caps win. Braden Holtby with an absolutely, the adjective escaped me here. Sick, unreal, how did he do that? Oh my goodness, he did what type save on Alex Tuch with 2 minutes remaining in the third period of game 2, where he was going one way, Tuch got the puck and was lining up to just bury the biscuit in the basket, and here comes Holtby diving back across the crease, stick out, wham, says, you'll get nothing, and not only like it, but be thankful for it. And I'm watching the game, I'm sitting on my couch, and I literally jumped off my couch and went, holy sh! How did he do that? I mean, it was almost Doc Emmerich, who's one of the most brilliant play-by-play guys I've ever heard for hockey. I mean, if I would listen to watch a hockey game, I like seeing that he's calling the game. He about yelled score and then had to take it like, whoa, he made the save. It was unbelievable. Now, I've dogged the Caps pretty much all the playoffs, expecting them to collapse. I'm probably going to give them the kiss of death here, but I think the Caps can win the Stanley Cup, believe it or not. I'm probably going to be hated in Washington, D.C., which wouldn't be the first time, but I think the Caps will win the series in 6. I think they'll win games 3 and 4 in Washington. Vegas will win in 1 in front of their crazy crowd in game 5 to give them a happy send-off. But the nation's capital will celebrate its first pro sports title in over 25 years. You heard it here first. I think the Caps are going to win the Stanley Cup. To the chagrin of Maple Leaf fans, to the chagrin of St. Louis Blue fans, yes, Brian, I'm talking to you, to the chagrin of so many other fans who have been waiting decades for their team to win the Stanley Cup, at least it won't be Vegas on the Cup, not yet, but this team could be etching their name on the Stanley Cup, and that right soon. This is a team that's built to last. Let's take a quick pivot to Fat Dap and Head Slap. Right now on my TV, believe it or not, before the before game 1 of the NBA Finals, is the Scripps Howard Scripps Howard Spelling Bee. And I'm looking at some of these kids that are on here. 9, 10, 11, 12. No, none older than 13. Spelling out words that I have never seen, much less heard of, much less trying to spell. I was in a spelling bee some 30 some odd years ago in the sixth grade. I couldn't spell acrobat. No, I take that back. I lost on acrobat. I couldn't spell accountant, which explains why I'm good, why I'm horrible at math. But some of the words that are in this are just mind-blowing. I have to give fat dap to all of the kids that have made it to Washington, D.C. for the National Spelling Bee, because they're spelling some damn hard words. If you ever get a chance, watch the movie. It's a movie came out about 12, 15 years ago. It's called Akilah and the Bee. And it's a great movie. The actors in it just all of a sudden have escaped me. But if you can, find that movie and watch it, and you will see some of the words that these kids have to learn how to spell. And there's a way that they can train themselves to learn how to spell these words. It's fascinating. I give all the dap in the world to these kids for being able to spell these incredibly hard words under the pressure of the national spotlight, because they show the spelling bee on ESPN every year. Give it up to these kids. Now, the head slap of the week goes to Brian Colangelo of the Philadelphia 76ers. Now, the Sixers had, by all accounts, a breakthrough year, you know, making it to the second round of the playoffs. But Colangelo, who was the GM of the Sixers, may be in hot water after allegedly dissing players on an anonymous burner Twitter account. Now, if these allegations prove to be true, Colangelo needs to get the gate. What does doing this prove? What is sending out nasty tweets about Joel Embiid or Ben Simmons or their coach Brett Brown or the organization in general? What does it prove? It doesn't prove anything. It proves even less if you are the GM hiding behind something to drum up fake outrage. And it's something that it seems has been the norm as of late. You've got to drum up some sort of outrage for people to pay attention to you. Something like that is just wrong. And someone like Brian Colangelo, who is from a very well-respected family of basketball lifers. I mean, his dad, Jerry Colangelo, worked with USA Basketball for the longest time, was with the Phoenix Suns, kept them a respectable team for decades. He should know better. If these allegations are true, he does not deserve to work in any kind of professional sports capacity ever again. It's silly. It's immature. And he should know better. Again, I'm hoping that these allegations are found to be baseless. But if not, he deserves one of the biggest head slaps of them all. We'll take a timeout, come back with the week's final word from the wood after this.